viewers, today we are back at Madras Palace and with our cooking segment. Santha is here with us with some more delicious recipes for you. So let me say hi to Santha. Hi Santha, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Okay, so what have you brought us today?
Today I am going to show chicken 65. This is very popular in our restaurant. Our customers love it so much, so I thought, you know, I will show to our viewers how we make the chicken 65.
Okay. If I've heard about chicken 65. Mm-hmm. So what is the specialty about your chicken 65?
This one is very different than the other ones. This is a dry form of chicken and it's not deep fried.
Oh, so it is very health consciously made chicken?
Yes. And what I do is I take the, you can even take the boneless, mm-hmm. Chicken, you know, the dark meat or the chicken breast. You can use either chicken breast or the chicken thigh meat, mm-hmm. and cut into small pieces like this, mm-hmm. and put in a little bit of turmeric, chili powder, and this is the coriander powder, this is the fennel powder, and black pepper and salt. Mm-hmm. And marinate it like this, mm-hmm. and keep it 2-3.
So you add fennel powder, this is the difference, essence to it, you know?
Yeah, fennel powder, yes. Fennel powder, turmeric powder, chili powder, coriander powder. And marinate it for 2-3 hours and keep it aside.
Okay, so we have to keep it in the fridge or outside?
Outside.
Outside. Okay.
Then what you can do is, you can, instead of using the stove, you can bake it in the oven.
Oh, that's
so
good.
So it will cook by itself in its own oil. Okay. So it's more, you know,
healthy and less fattening.
Less fattening.
Yeah, because most of the people are very health conscious and they would really appreciate this dish because it is according to what the demand of the time is, that less oil and more natural stuff.
Yes, and this is the baked form of chicken.
Okay.
Okay.
So after this, when you bake it, it turns like this.
Yes.
Okay.
And again, the third, you know, section is that I use a small wok, mm-hmm. like this, and put in the stove and put a little bit of oil. That's it. Mm-hmm. And then put in the red chilies and curry leaves and fried onion. Mm-hmm. And stir it for a little 1 or 2 minutes like this.
Okay.
And put in the baked chicken. Stir for 1 or 2 minutes. Then you have to add a little more spices in. Little chili powder again.
Yeah, chili powder you add according to your own taste.
Yeah.
Like if you like
if you
spicy,
want more spicy, you can add more. Yeah. Then the coriander powder, then a little black pepper powder. Mm-hmm. And this is the ilachi cardamom powder. So then you mix it well. And leave it on the stove. Leave it for about 5 minutes to get it. Mm-hmm. If you want, you can put little more fried onion according to your taste. I love the fried onion and the curry leaves. Why I put more curry leaves in here? Curry leaves is very good for your health. It prevents, you know, cancer and it controls, you know, diabetes.
Oh, that's good.
It controls the sugar level in your body. So probably that's why, you know, in Indian cooking for years people were using
a lot of curry leaves.
Yeah, it's very, very healthy.
So it's a good recipe which is healthy and will help you in, will benefit your health too, right?
Yeah, I hope so, and my customers love it.
Viewers, if you would like to come and enjoy this chicken 65, and which is the specialty of Madras Palace, I think you should run and come to Madras Palace and first enjoy the real taste of the dish and then try it at home. And thank you very much.
Hello everybody, we are here at Madras Palace. As you know, they bring a lovely segment, delicious food recipes for you guys. Today we are lucky to have the owner, Mr. Prashottam, and his wife. I welcome you in Ye Karavan.
Thank you.
Reason we are here today with you is because today is a very special day because you're going to teach us something which is very unique,
yes.
Never been done before,
yes.
By anybody according to you.
Yes.
So what is that special thing?
This is a very special recipe.
Mm-hmm.
It's called uthapam.
Okay.
Pizza uthapam.
Okay.
Normally Italians have pizza.
Okay.
But this is South Indian way to make pizza uthapam.
Okay. So it's like you're mixing up South Indian word and the Italian. So it's a pizza,
yeah.
Which you guys make it.
That's right.
Okay.
And that is her recipe.
Okay.
She created this. And
okay.
The main ingredients for this one.
Mm-hmm.
This is a green pepper,
mm-hmm.
Coriander,
right.
And the cheese,
right.
Mushroom,
mm-hmm.
Tomato,
mm-hmm.
yellow pepper,
right.
And curry leaves.
Okay.
And this is a red pepper.
Okay.
And so the mixer she make it.
Basically, it's like ingredients are all similar to pizza.
Yeah.
Right. But yeah. It's just like the layer you're going to use is more like how you make dosa and other
dosa,
things.
Dosa.
Yes. Okay. So she came up with this thing and you supported her. And again, just like this beautiful restaurant, you guys have this beautiful recipe going on, right?
That's right. Yeah.
So what do you say? Let's go and watch how they make it. So can you explain us?
Yeah. And now she's going to put some oil first.
See, I love this part of little oil.
Yeah,
it's not too much oil in any of it.
Not too much oil.
Yeah, that's...
The dough normally throw it up.
Yes.
We make it in the tawa.
I see. You see, there you go with tawa. It tastes east and west together in it, right?
East and west mixed together.
Mixed together.
Now she's putting the cheese.
Cheese on it, I see.
Yeah. Because first the cheese, that will absorb the dough.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And I see the proportions are very carefully. It's not that they're putting too much.
Not too much.
Because of course, we are very health conscious people, right?
That's right.
As you all know, we are very health conscious and we are always caring about heart and everything. We the South Indians or the whole Indian region, I would say.
And they can use olive oil.
Okay.
And the ingredients and all, fresh ingredients.
Okay. You know this recipe by heart, looks like. So you know a lot about cooking too.
So almost all the recipes are created by her.
Uh-huh.
And both of us, we work hard. And before serving anything, normally we try.
So she's putting mushrooms now on it?
Yeah, mushroom now. And then yellow pepper.
I love the colors, nice.
Yeah. Like a rangoli.
Yes.
Yeah.
The yellows, the reds, all the vegetables, you know, are going in there. And the greens. It actually looks like a pizza.
Yeah, exactly like a pizza.
Yes.
Yeah. But the taste is different and people will enjoy it.
And it's lighter, I guess, because it's not that hard crust.
Yeah, hard crust.
The crust is not that hard.
Yeah.
This is good.
Yeah. the art of cooking, you know. Pizza making is an art, same way they're cooking, you know.
But people who enjoy meat, they can also add some meat.
They can make
meat. Yeah, meat can be added to this.
They can do the meat also. Mm-hmm. Karelis is very important in South Indian cooking.
Right.
And it's very healthy also.
Sure.
And a little bit coriander.
Coriander on the end.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
That Eastern nice smell, eh?
Yeah.
Yes,
you can smell
that's
it.
What. So it's quite milder, right? Yeah.
If you need, you can put some crushed chili.
Okay.
You can make it very spicy.
Very spicy. If you want, you can add those things. But there's very little. Right now, this is a very mild kind of thing going on. Yeah, it's a tinge of oil you're putting again, a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. Either.
Very
so
little
that
on
don't
it. Yes.
On the
yes. I realize this thing. Most of the things are not greasy, oily here.
No, nowadays people doesn't want much oily food. Oily food, you know.
And how long it will take if you leave it like this?
Yeah, it'll take about 4 or 5 minutes.
4 or 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, and I see here, very similar to what you're doing there. So you're actually spreading the oil like that too.
That's right.
And this is how your final product looks like, eh?
Yeah.
So basically it becomes thin and it's nice. It's not too hard.
It's not very thin.
Oh, it's not. Actually, it is very nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to break a piece of this.
Yeah.
Very good. I tell you one thing, you should come to Madras Palace and try this thing, Richmond Hill. And you know what? What about dinner for two?
Yeah.
Whoever calls caller number 11 and 17?
Yep. Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
He committed here. If you're caller number 11 and 17, you're going to have dinner for two as a compliments of Madras Palace. So give him a call. Number is in front of you. And I think you guys can enjoy this thing. Recipe is going to be given to you once we finish this segment. You can even make it at home. But it's better first to try here. Okay?
Take care.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello everybody and welcome back to Madras Palace, Richmond Hill. We are here today with the master chef, owner, guru, Santha ji, and Kanan, who will be assisting, and he's also a chef here. We welcome you in Ye Karma, and a lot of people have a very wonderful complaint, actually, I would say. The complaint is that last time when you were on our show, you taught them how to make idli. But then you promised that we're going to show how to make sambar after and chutney. Now the question is...
How to make sambar.
Yes, and they're calling and they're asking. I'm pretty sure you had this problem too, people calling you guys.
Yeah.
I see today you are prepared, so I'm going to leave the floor for you and please explain us and the viewers.
This is the sambar that we have already made.
This is what everybody's asking for.
Yeah, for our restaurant, okay. Mm-hmm. Sambar is... main thing that you know we use in our restaurant with idli. Vadas and doshas, you know, and even with rice. It's very popular in South India.
I see.
Especially in Tamil Nadu, Kerala and all. And there are different types of sambar.
Okay.
And we mainly use in sambar the lentil.
I see.
And any type of vegetable we can use.
Okay.
So it's a, what should I say, it's a very good vegetable curry that goes well with the rice.
I see.
But you can use it, and people eat with the idli, dosa,
yes,
and vada, so it is a must that you know sambar should be there in South India.
So let's begin. How do you guys make this thing?
Blender.
Okay.
And this is the cook blender.
Oh, it's more like in Indian they call it dal.
Dal, yes.
Right, okay.
And
this is
the coriander powder, turmeric powder,
okay,
and chili powder,
okay,
and salt, and all the vegetables we have put, the onion, tomatoes, and drumstick.
Right.
And this is the okra.
Okra there, okay.
Yeah, okra.
So and basically a lot of things are here, that's green chilies.
Yeah. First when we make it, we had to use about 2 glasses of, you know, for home use, we had to use about 2 glasses of water and let it boil. Can you show Kannan how we are doing it here? See, actually sambar exists in 19th century.
Okay, 19th
century. And lentils are, you know the origin. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Lentils and origin is from, Egypt 5,000 years ago.
Oh, wow. Well, that's quite old history about this. Mm-hmm. Now tomatoes are, you were telling us, yeah.
Yeah, in sambar, people normally use tamarind.
Right.
But we use tomato paste because tomatoes are very good for, our body. Mm-hmm. It prevents, cancer.
Right.
And it has got an antioxidant called lycopene.
Yes.
So it prevents the cancer of the lungs and stomach.
As we always tell our audience, you guys are very health conscious.
Yes.
And you guys serve everything which is very according to the Canadian health guides. And
yes.
Which is a wonderful thing.
A half teaspoon of turmeric.
Okay.
Okay. Then, and half, we don't want to make it very hot, so half teaspoon of, chili powder.
Okay.
2 to 3 teaspoons of,
Okay.
Coriander powder.
Okay.
And the...
Oh, is there a green...
Two, three green chilies.
Okay.
And we let it boil for some time.
After that is being done, now you're going to start adding all the...
Vegetables.
Vegetables, which are like tomatoes, I see it.
Tomatoes, onions. Pearl onion.
Oh, so these are...
This is a pearl onion.
Pearl onions, you guys put it there too.
And we can use the eggplant, but today we don't have the eggplant here.
So you're using it, okay, pearl onions.
Pearl onions.
Are they with vinegar or they're...
No.
Just plain.
Yeah,
okay.
Plain.
Okay.
And the drumsticks.
Okay.
It's very famous in India.
Yeah.
The popular. And
okra has to be in there
the
too.
End,
okay.
When it boils,
mm-hmm.
put in the sambar powder. Sambar powder. About two.
So when it gets to the boiling stage, you guys are putting right now, but really, actually, when it starts boiling, that's the time when you add this thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's according to your taste, okay?
Okay.
You can put the sambar.
Is it a little spicy?
Yeah. Okay. It's according to your taste. You can put the sambar powder in. Did you put the salt, Kannan? Please put.
Okay. So basically, most of the ingredients you put according to your own taste in this.
Yes.
Okay.
Because some people like mild, some people like, hot. So it's according to your taste that, you can put the
spices. So now how long do we let it cook?
About until the vegetables are cooked, about 20 minutes, 20 to 25 minutes it takes minimum to get it cooked. And when it is cooked well, you can put in the tomato paste about...
So when it's for 20 minutes, we let it cook, and after that, we will add the tomato paste in there.
About 3 to 4 teaspoons.
Okay. Okay, so there are certain proportions for according to 2 glasses of water we are talking here. In 2 glasses of water, this is how much you're adding it. Okay.
And I put in a little bit of, tamarind also.
Okay.
Otherwise, it's not, sour.
So it's just a little tip of the spoon.
Sour.
I see. What are these, basil or? That's at the end. Okay.
See, when it is boiling, you can put a little bit of coriander leaf and curry leaf also to give the flavor of the sambar. Okay, then only when it boils, it gets the, just put it in.
Just the extra flavor you want to add before also a little bit. Okay.
Then you had to. Cook well.
Mm-hmm.
That's enough.
So basically, you're going to leave this now for a good 20-25 minutes. Yes. Cook, vegetables are all cooked. And that's why you put a little bit of curry leaves.
Mm-hmm.
So the juice will actually make it better.
Yes.
So Let's wait and see how at the end it's going to look. Okay, 20 minutes are gone, so now what we do?
Yeah, we are seasoning the...
Okay, you're seasoning it, okay. Wow.
No.
The oil needs to get a little warm.
Yeah,
okay.
Warm, then.
And did the mustard seeds?
Yeah, put in the mustard seeds and okay. Let it splutter. We had to let it crack. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, let us.
What else goes in there?
Curry. 2-3.
Oh, these are the dry.
The dry.
Okay. Pepper. And, curry leaf.
And coriander leaf.
A little bit of coriander in this, okay. Looks good. It's seasoned with tomatoes, actually.
Yeah,
okay.
It's tomato. More flavor and taste for the sambar.
That's very good. Even the color looks so good on it.
Yeah, put it on.
Okay?
Yeah, put it there.
Okay.
For added taste,
Yeah. You eat
in Italy with chutney and sambar.
Chutney and sambar.
And we'll show how we are going to make the chutney afterwards.
Right. This segment, we're gonna show this, and the next we will have chutney and something else for our audience.
Okay.
So if you guys want to enjoy this delicious thing, which I'm gonna do once this segment is done, you can come to Madras Palace at Richmond Hill. You can get their number from our commercial break. Once again, thank you very much for both
thank
of you.
You,
and we're gonna get you back within a week. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
Rice,
It's called tamarind rice.
Tamarind rice, okay.
Or puliyada rice.
Okay, so we're gonna show you in a bit how to make tamarind rice.
It's very popular in South India. In South Indian temples, they give it as a prasad, you know, like when you go there, they after the puja.
Right, so as a prasad they give you. Okay,
yeah,
no
so,
problem.
So it's very popular, you know, in South India. So we give it in Madras Palace with our buffet.
Very wonderful. Let's see how it makes. So, as we were saying, we are all ready to show you how to make tamarind rice. Now, again, Santha, tamarind rice, how it started, who eats, a little bit background about it.
Mm-hmm.
From, again, is it a South Indian?
Yes.
Okay.
And tamarind is very popular in South... Tamarind rice is very popular in South India.
Okay.
And in Tamil Nadu and Kerala, we all eat it. Especially in temples, we give it as prasad.
Okay.
And it's a very, you know, tasty... Very tasty and easy to prepare.
Easy to prepare, that's a key thing.
Yeah, easy to prepare. And the mouth-watering, tangy taste of the tamarind, you get it. You know?
Okay.
You feel like eating it.
So let's learn. I think everybody wants to know how to make them.
Okay, we have to have the cooked rice.
Oh, okay.
This is the cooked rice, kept it aside.
Okay.
And
these are normal steamed rice.
Yes.
Steamed cooked rice, okay.
And this is the... Puliyodhara powder.
Okay.
You know, there's a recipe to make it, but it's very easy to buy it from the store.
What is it called again?
This is the Puliyodhara powder.
Puliyodhara powder.
Puliyodhara powder.
Okay.
This is a tamarind rice, but this is a tamarind powder that is already made and that you can buy it from the store, grocery store.
Okay.
And this is the tamarind.
Okay.
And mustard seeds. Urad dal.
Right.
And red chilies and the chana dal and the curry leaves and salt to taste and the
very special thing. I saw that.
Yeah, this is the what do you call this one? Dasavatthana powder.
Okay.
That also we use a little bit for the added taste and oil.
So I think move on. Let's see how to make that. So you take the oil.
About 1 or 2 teaspoon of oil.
Okay, not too much oil.
Not too much. 1 or 2 teaspoon of oil. That's okay. When it's hot, we put in the
mustard seeds.
Okay. Warm it and then put that.
Yeah.
And over the dal, you put that
dal
in. Okay.
And the red chilies. About 2 to 3, you know, you can break it and put in there, or you know, you can put straight.
Okay.
And the curry leaf. Normally people use the peanuts, but here we don't use it in our restaurant.
Do you add the salt before, or salt is later, you get that?
Later.
Okay.
I was just saying, you know, normally people use peanuts, but in our restaurant we don't use peanuts because people have allergy.
A lot of people have, you're right.
So avoid that.
It's okay. So 1 spoon of that? Two.
Not two.
Okay.
Spoons. And then you have to put, there's the hot water level.
How much water are you guys going to add? There's approximately around one glass?
About 2 to 3 tablespoons.
Very little water.
Okay, not too much.
Oh.
2 to 3.
Okay.
A little more, and I think. Okay, mix it, okay. Okay, then a half teaspoon. Mix it well. And a little bit of, you know, tamarind paste also.
So that creates a sourness.
And yes.
Yeah. Okay.
And
that's a magical bottle you have.
Yeah.
That.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a fatira powder. And pour it into the already cooked rice. Okay.
I think this is the quickest recipe I've ever seen, even I can make it. You know, a person like me who knows how to make steamed rice only should be able to make these kind of, yes.
Very easy and very tasty and very popular in South India.
It gives a very nice food.
Has medicinal values also. I have read in paper magazines like that, if you use the tamarind paste with, you know, warm water and garlic, you know, it's good for your throat.
If you want to eat and enjoy this delicious product, you can always come to Madras Palace, and Santha would be here for you. And it is delicious indeed. The reason we have tried most of the products before showing it to you, we always try to make sure they are actually what these people claim. And I would say, you should come here and try. You can get the recipe after the show, but definitely it's highly recommended. Thank you very much, and we're going to have you back in our show.
Okay, thank you very
Thanks
much.
Thanks a lot.
Welcome, Nazreen. Aaj hamare saath Madras Palace ki owner Santha phir se maujood hai, jo ke last week inhone hame appam banane ki recipe sikhayi thi. To aaj ye hame batayengi ki hum appam kis ke saath khayenge. Inhone do cheeze batayi thi ki appam आप या तो वेजिटेरियन स्टू के साथ खा सकते हैं, चिकन के साथ, या स्पेशल कैरक एग्स के साथ. बट आज ये हमें जो रेसिपी बता रही हैं वो चिकन स्टू की है. तो वेलकम शांता. आर व्यूअर्स वुड लाइक टू नो द रेसिपी ऑफ द डिलिशियस चिकन करी विच वी कैन हैव विद द अपम. सो वुड यू लाइक टू टेल अस व्हाट आर द इंग्रेडिएंट्स एंड हाउ डू यू मेक इट?
यस, दिस इज द, you know, boneless chicken that's cooked in the microwave. And this is the boiled potatoes and frozen peas and coconut milk, ginger cut. This ginger has to be cut lengthwise, and the onion cut lengthwise, curry leaves and fried onion, bay leaf and cloves and crushed cardamom, and I use crushed black pepper also. I forgot to put some. And the garlic cut lengthwise, and the meat masala powder, and the green chili cut lengthwise.
Okay, is it something different from the curry powder, or
it's a yes, exactly. This
is a different,
the same.
Okay, so we can use curry powder if you don't have the meat masala powder.
Curry powder or garam masala powder.
Garam masala. Okay.
And you don't have to even use that. Still, you can make a chicken stew.
Oh, that's really nice. Okay. So after we cook this for how long in the microwave?
About 10 minutes, you know, if you put in a, like a, you get a cooker that you can use in the microwave.
Okay.
And put in there and cook it good and keep it aside.
Okay.
So then start making the stew. Mm-hmm. First, you know, take a cooking pot and put in the oil, vegetable oil or olive oil.
Okay.
Cut onion, mm-hmm. Green chili and curry leaves and
garlic
and ginger and what do you call the bay leaf, mm-hmm. and the cloves and everything put in there and saute it for about 2 to 3 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Chicken
and potatoes and the frozen peas, mm-hmm. and put salt and add enough water to cook it.
Okay, so it looks like a little curryish look.
Yes,
it'll have,
yeah.
Right.
Then when the curry is boiled, mm-hmm. enough, you can pour the coconut milk.
Okay, so this is the last thing which you, yeah. would add
the
to your curry.
Coconut milk and curry powder.
Curry powder.
A teaspoon or half, or 2 teaspoon of curry powder.
Curry.
What it's like according to your taste.
So how long do we have to cook after we mix everything, the chicken and potatoes and the coconut milk and curry powder? Do we close it right away or let it simmer for a while?
Yeah, let it
simmer for a while till it becomes the proper consistency.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, then at the end you put in the fried onion and curry leaves. I think earlier I said also you had to use the curry leaves, mm-hmm. but you had to keep little bit to add at the end
for the
good flavor.
To, yes, yeah. to come out.
And a little bit of oil also.
Yeah. Okay.
So it gives a good stew.
Stew. Okay, so आज आप लोगों ने स्टू की रेसिपी सीखी और उससे पहले हमने आपको अपम की रेसिपी बताई थी. तो आप बिल्कुल ट्राई करिए घर में, और अगर घर में अच्छा ना बने तो मद्रास पहले ज़रूर आइए, क्योंकि यहाँ की तो बहुत ही लजीज डिशेस हैं. और आई होप आप लोग घर पे भी ट्राई करेंगे, बल्कि पहले यहाँ आकर इसका मज़ा लीजिए, उसके बाद अपने घर में ट्राई करिए. हेलो नाज़रीन, आज हम दोबारा आपके पास मद्रास पैलेस से मौजूद हैं, जो कि रिचमंड हिल में लोकेटेड है, और मेरे साथ वहाँ की ओनर शांता बैठी हुई हैं, जो आज आपको कोई और नई रेसिपी बताएंगी. इससे पहले कि वो बताएं, हम उनसे ये पूछते हैं कि भाई लास्ट टाइम उन्होंने जो फ्री डिनर और लंच दिए थे उसका रिस्पॉन्स कैसा रहा. सो हाय शांता, हाउ आर यू?
How
did you like? Did you get good response from the show after you gave the free dinner and lunch?
Yes, we had a lot of people, you know, on Sunday, mm-hmm. and they all enjoyed our doshas.
So I just want to know, what are you going to tell us about what is the new recipe you're going to tell us about today?
In Kerala, there's a popular like dish called. It's not really a dish like dosa. Mm-hmm. Kerala appam. Appam is made of rice, long grain rice, and a grated coconut, and what else we put in, yeast. And it's a long process, but I can give the recipe.
Yes, you know, our viewers would really love to see, mm-hmm. and how you make it and what are the ingredients. So we have some things in front of us. This is some sugar.
Yes, and this long grain.
Long grain basmati rice.
Raw rice and grated coconut. Mm-hmm. And we need a little pinch of salt. Mm-hmm. And then this is cooked, and half cup of cooked rice.
And what is this?
Yeast.
This is yeast.
Yeah, we should be using about half teaspoon of yeast for this appam. And you can use sugar. I don't know whether I told you about the sugar. We had to use the sugar.
Sugar to make it a little
sweet.
So it takes away the bitterness of the, you can say, rice and yeast. If you add a little sugar, it makes it a little bit sweeter.
Oh, about 3 teaspoons of sugar you can use. It's according to your taste.
So, okay, and how do we eat? Like, you know, how do we eat this appam just by itself, or there's special like dish to eat it with, or is it complete by itself or what?
No, you can eat the appam either with chicken stew or vegetable stew or Kerala egg roast. First, you know, you have to soak the rice in water for about 6 hours. Then, you know, you have to strain it and keep it aside, and take the long grain rice in a blender with cooked rice, grated coconut, and grind it. Add, you know, enough water to make it a thick consistency.
Yeah, this is like a pancake, it's better like or a little bit thicker, than,
thicker
that.
Than that?
Little bit thicker than that. And then how do you make it? Do you, then I think you told, like, do you add some yeast to it, because we can see it
then,
here?
Then you have to keep, take about 1 teaspoon of yeast and put it in warm water along with a little bit of salt and sugar, and keep it about 10 minutes to, for the fermentation process. Mm-hmm. And when the mixture is ready, you had to put the, what do you call, the yeast, keep it for about 6 to 8 hours.
Oh, okay. So you can do it sometimes overnight if you have to make them in the morning.
Yes.
Okay.
And you need a special non-stick frying pan.
To be honest, I just tried before we started the program your appam with the chicken stew. They were really amazing and delicious. So I think we are going to come back with the recipe which you made me eat right now. That is the chicken stew, and which is so delicious with the appams. So thank you for today, and we'll come back with the recipe of the chicken stew next time. ناظرین آج ہم پھر مدراس پیلس میں شانتا کے ساتھ آئے ہوئے ہیں اور آج یہ اڈلی سکھانے کے لیے ہمیں آئی ہیں تو میری ان سے بہت فرمائش تھی کیونکہ لوگ بہت کہا کرتے تھے کہ بھائی ہمیں اڈلی بنانا سیکھنا چاہتے ہیں بیکاز اٹس اے ویری پاپولر ڈش سو لیٹس سی واٹ شی ہیز ٹو سے اباؤٹ اٹ
Today I'm going to show a special type of idli that's good for all ages that can eat and it's made of urad dal and semolina or suji
okay
I use you know 1 cup of urad dal mm-hmm. and 2.5 cups of you know semolina now first what I do is I keep soak the you know urad dal in water
mm-hmm.
for about 5 to 6 hours and suji I steam it and keep it beforehand
okay so how do you steam the suji like you put it in
the steamer yeah
so it becomes soft
yeah you know you have to first you know steam it and keep it aside
on the side okay
yeah. and this one the urad dal you soak it in water
mm-hmm.
and then when it is okay after 5 to 6 hours you have to grind it like a paste
mm-hmm.
and add enough water to make it a batter should be of this yeah. consistency you know
yeah
so when it's ground properly you have to add the suji
in
little
it.
By little and mix it well and keep it for fermentation overnight
oh okay so you leave it for overnight and but you soak this and blend this but you don't blend this
no,
with
no,
this
no, no,
you
no.
do it separately
when it is ground properly
mm-hmm.
and you add the you know steamed suji
okay
like little by little like this
slowly
yeah, yeah. so then you know you have to mix it
so this is like a very high protein idli because usually it's made up of rice
mm-hmm.
that's your own new recipe so I think people even who are on protein diet mm-hmm. they would be able to try this and it won't be harmful for them
it's one thing it's a steamed and then I don't use any rice so it's good for people who are diabetic so I prefer to make this one in my home
that's really nice okay so will you show us how to steam it
This is a traditional idli steamer so mm-hmm. it is already steamed so what I do is
I can see the steam coming and the water boiling
so I take it in and you have to put a little bit of oil
mm-hmm.
like this take it pour the idli batter into this katoras like this
yeah so they are the shape is like you know so it stays one size and shaped up nicely
yeah okay. and you can fill the three or you know trays like that in this
okay.
one the whole thing the same way you can you know put the batter and then put it in the idli
maker
idli maker and then cover it tight keep it for about you had to boil it for 15 to 20 minutes though.
So Shanta, now it's almost 20 minutes. So let's see how your idli has come out.
Yeah, it's ready. Now I'll show you.
Thing.
A little bit hot. Okay. I'll take it out.
Oh, wow.
You take it like this. These are my healthy idlis for you.
Okay, I'm going to try them with little bit sambar and chutney.
It goes
and
with,
which I think you'll have to give us the recipe.
We have the sambar next time.
Next time. So, I hope you will come here to enjoy idli and sambar too. Right now, it's my time. So come back to Madras Palace and have your own fun. Welcome back, Nazreen. Today, we are taking a delicious dish in front of you. And with me, as usual, Shanta is from Madras Palace. So, Shanta, so what are you going to show us today? I can see a lot of fish here.
Yeah, today I'm going to show you the baked salmon and the pan-fried salmon also.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the salmon steaks.
Mm-hmm.
And the, okay, and this is the marinated salmon steaks.
Oh, so you already marinated it earlier? So
yes. And this is a mixture of the spices that I ground and kept it. I use chili powder, turmeric powder, black pepper, garlic, and onion, and salt, and a little bit of lemon juice, mm-hmm. and oil to make the paste.
Okay.
Of the.
So how much do you use? Like, for example, if you have like 6 pieces of the fish, how much are you going to use? Like one onion or two onions?
Yeah,
or
like one big.
Because basically, I can see this is all made by onion. The rest of the things are just for the flavor.
Yeah, okay.
So the paste is basically made by.
Yeah, you can use one big onion, mm-hmm. and a teaspoon full of ground
garlic.
Mm-hmm. And like half teaspoon of turmeric, mm-hmm. and 1 teaspoon, 1 to 2 teaspoon of chili powder,
yeah,
and salt, and probably 1 teaspoon of lemon juice, with little bit of olive oil, and grind it and make it a thick paste like this.
Okay, and how long do we need to marinate the fish?
About 30 minutes.
30 minutes in
yes.
advance. So
yeah.
you marinate the fish and you leave it so the flavor really gets into the meat.
For 30 or 40 minutes, like it says, especially salmon, you know,
mm-hmm.
it gets the flavor.
Flavor.
So keep it 30 minutes. Then if you want to bake it,
mm-hmm.
you know, keep the oven on for about half an hour or 45 minutes at 300 degrees centigrade, 300 to 325 degrees centigrade. Then when the marinated fish is ready,
mm-hmm.
put the fish in the oven and keep it around 15 to 20 minutes.
Okay, so this one you already baked.
Yeah, it is ready.
So yeah, and right now you're going to show us how to pan fry
it.
Okay.
See, people, especially youngsters, they like the pan fried or fried fish.
Yeah,
so
for health conscious people,
yeah, this is
you can put it in the oven, but it tastes better when you pan fry.
Yeah, and pan fry, you have to use only, you know, a little bit of olive oil. It's
mm-hmm.
a very healthy for you, especially people who have heart problem, diabetic problem, things like that. So you have to use the olive oil. And salmon steak, why I chose salmon steak? Salmon, you know, if you eat salmon, even you are, you know, what do you call, your, you know, arthritis. See, if you eat continuously salmon for a long time,
even the Health Canada really recommends us to have this fish.
The arthritis and again the heart.
Heart.
Yeah. The omega-3 fatty acids, it has.
Yeah, it's very high in omega-3.
So you can, that's why we use mostly here the salmon. Okay. And how do I pan fry it? See, just you can see, just a little bit of oil. Put the salmon steaks in slowly.
Shanta, what I really like about your food is that your food is made with really, you guys are very health conscious. So most of the things I've learned here, it's like it's good for your health. It's not like too much fried stuff or too much cholesterol in it, or you're like, you know, everything. And is that the food you always serve for your customers too?
Of course, we do the salmon. baked or kingfish baked here.
Yeah. So we can come here and
the baked fish.
Like the viewers can come here and enjoy the food, but don't have to worry about, oh my God, after I leave here, we'll gain like 10 pounds of weight.
No, every day we give the baked fish.
Oh, that's really nice.
Lunch buffet or the dinner buffet.
See, when you go and you have like fish at other restaurants, it's almost like fried in deep oil and stuff. So that's the best thing, that the food is made with consideration.
Yeah, like about people's health, you know, we think about people's health.
Yeah.
Then 2-3 minutes if you put it. Yes. You take an hour. It takes only 5 to 6 minutes to do the pan frying. It's very, very easy. Very easy to make it, and it's very good to eat, very tasty and healthy.
Yeah, and it's one of the best fish.
Yes.
And especially after being cooked by your beautiful hands and your nice recipe, it should be very delicious.
Yeah, I hope so, you know, if you test like that, you know. I think
it's... No, we have a lot of people who always call us and let us know that, like, you know, we went to Madras Palace and we tried the food and that was really, really nice and tasty. So that means you're a good cook. Oil, and it's done so nicely and it's brown and looks really pretty. Wow, Santha, this looks delicious and very beautifully presented. So this is the fish which you had already baked it,
and this is
the one you just pan fry it.
So I forgot to tell you, before pan frying, you can put the fish in the microwave and cook it for about 5 to 6 minutes, then pan fry it.
Oh, that can save the time, right?
Time, and it's more delicious.
More delicious. So thank you, Santha. I think this was a very good recipe. So of course you can come, you can always come to Madras Palace to try their delicious food. So thank you again, Santha, and see you next time. Hello Nazreen, aaj hum phir Madras Palace mein Santha ke saath aaye hue hain aur aaj ye इडली सिखाने के लिए हमें आई हैं. तो मेरी इनसे बहुत फरमाइश थी, क्योंकि लोग बहुत कहा करते थे कि भाई हमें इडली बनाना सीखना चाहते हैं, बिकॉज इट्स अ वेरी पॉपुलर डिश. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट शी हैज टू से अबाउट इट.
टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो ए स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ इडली दैट्स गुड फॉर ऑल एजेस दैट कैन ईट. And it's made of urad dal and semolina or suji.
Suji,
yeah,
okay.
I use, you know, 1 cup of urad dal, mm-hmm. and 2.5 cups of, you know, semolina. Now, first what I do is I keep soak the, you know, urad dal in water,
mm-hmm.
for about 5 to 6 hours. And suji, I steam it and keep it beforehand.
Okay, so how do you steam the suji? Like you put it in
the steamer.
Steamer,
yeah.
So it becomes soft.
Yeah, you know, you have to first, you know, steam it and keep it aside.
On the side, okay.
Yeah. And this one, the urad dal, you soak it in water,
mm-hmm.
and then when it is okay, after 5 to 6 hours, you have to grind it like a paste,
mm-hmm.
and add enough water to make it a. Batter should be of this consistency, you know.
Yeah.
So when it's ground properly, you have to add the suji
in
little
it.
By little and mix it well and keep it for fermentation overnight.
Oh, okay. So you leave it for overnight, and but you soak this and blend this, but you don't blend this with this.
No,
you
no.
do it separately.
When it is ground properly,
mm-hmm.
and you add the, you know, steamed suji,
okay.
like little by little like this.
Slowly, yeah.
Yeah, so then, you know, you have to mix it.
So this is like a very high protein idli, because usually it's made up of rice.
Mm-hmm.
That's your own new recipe. So I think people, even who are on protein diets, they would be able to try this, and it won't be harmful for them.
Yeah, it's one thing, it's a steam, and then I don't use any rice. So it's good for people who are diabetic. So I prefer to make this one in my home.
That's really nice. Okay, so will you show us how to steam it?
This is a traditional Italy steamer. So it is already steamed. So what I do is...
Yeah, I can see the steam coming and the water boiling.
So I take it in. And you have to put a little bit of oil.
Mm-hmm.
Like this. Take it. Pour the idli batter into this katoras like this.
Yeah, so they are the shape is like, you know, so it stays one size and shaped up nicely.
Yeah, okay. And you can fill the three or, you know, trays like that in this
okay.
one. The whole thing the same way you can, you know, put the batter and then put it in the idli
maker,
idli maker and then cover it tight. Keep it for about, you had to boil it for 15 to 20 minutes though.
So Shanta, now it's almost 20 minutes. So
yeah,
let's see how your idli has come out.
Yeah, it's ready. Now I'll show you.
It's
a little bit hot. Okay. I'll take it out.
Wow.
You take it like this. These are my healthy idlis for you.
Okay, I'm going to try them with little bit sambar and chutney.
It goes
and
with,
which I think you'll have to give us the recipe.
You have the sambar next time.
Next time. So, I hope you will come here to enjoy idli and sambar too. Right now, it's my time. So, come back to Madras Palace and have your own fun.
Hello everybody, and once again welcome back to Madras Palace, Richmond Hill. Last time you saw Shanta with her team doing a fantastic job teaching you guys how to make sambar. Now it is time to learn how to make the chutney. Now again, this is something a lot of South Indians eat. I have seen it, we have tried it,
the
wonderful.
Kakar chutney.
Yes, and this is not like a regular, what Indians make chutney. This is a little quite different actually.
Yeah.
A lot of ingredients are different. So take over from me and explain the viewers what they're gonna learn.
Yeah, this is a coconut chutney that we mainly use in our restaurant with that we give with idli
right.
and doshas.
Idli and dosa.
The masala
right.
doshas. It's very, very important that we should give the coconut chutney.
Okay.
Okay, and we use, you know, fresh scraped coconut to make the coconut chutney with the green chili and red chili and a little bit of onion and salt.
So basically, if salt is there, red, green,
and chili.
Okay.
And onion.
Okay.
Cut onion a little bit, we put in there.
Okay.
And with warm water.
Okay.
And salt.
Okay, I also see this is for a later purpose.
Yeah, when you season it.
Okay.
So
you season this thing too. That's why it looks so beautiful.
Yeah.
The nice fresh look on it. So I guess go ahead.
Can you show how we make it?
Yeah, sure.
So everybody's going to show how he's.
And you can narrate what he's doing everything on it.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is coconut, right?
Coconut is a main ingredient in South Indian cooking.
I see.
And even it's very popular in Africa also.
Okay. So basically, like, is it in proportion how much coconut you put it in, like, a small bowl? And
yeah, but, you know, people, they don't eat very hot, spicy chutney.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to use about two, three, you know,
I see.
Chilies.
Okay.
You know, if you like mild, you can either can even put one chili.
Okay.
So yeah, that's you know, that's enough. And
okay.
Two, you know, red chili also.
Okay.
Not two. It's very hot, you know, so that's enough. And put in a little bit of, you know, salt. Did you put salt, Kana?
Oh, okay. I can get you for sure salt here.
Yeah.
No problem.
Yeah, just a little bit. That's a little too much for this one. But yeah, okay.
So it's, again, it depends on how you like, if you eat salt a lot.
No, salty.
Very careful
with
that.
Yeah, very careful, according to the taste.
Right, yeah. Right.
It's a little warm water.
Mm-hmm.
Don't put, okay.
Now we're going to have hear some grindings.
Yeah.
So I think a viewer should get ready to hear some, there's a blender here, so it's going to do some blending.
Seasoning. Yeah.
Wow.
So
okay.
Where's the seasoning thing, Kana?
So you actually fry like
yeah,
take oil on it in.
Yeah.
Okay. What kind of oil you guys are using here?
We use the canola oil.
Okay. People
yeah,
come to your restaurant.
Yes.
And they can enjoy with canola oil. Hmm.
And the oil is, you know, hot. He has to put in the mustard seeds and urad dal and the curry leaf. And when all split this, then he can put in the,
okay,
you know, chutney in there.
Okay. So normally it's spicy. The chutney is normally
not very spicy.
Not very spicy.
No, people
okay.
cannot eat it, you know, because
mm-hmm.
it's very hot. So it goes very well with the, you know, doses. People love chutneys, especially the coconut chutney.
Definitely,
it's,
you know,
very popular in South
my
India.
My mouth is getting very watery.
Actually,
just looking at all this.
In northern part of India, they don't use, you know, that much coconut.
Right.
As we South Indians.
South Indians, yes.
So that,
right.
But yeah.
Yeah.
Not too much.
And this is what kind of, what ingredient is this?
That's a urad dal,
okay.
And the kind of black gram dal.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can put in the cisterna.
Okay.
Okay, then put in this.
Wow.
Curry
okay.
leaf.
The curry leaf, okay. See, the master chef always has to do the little, you
yeah.
know, magic touch with it,
yeah.
so it becomes even more delicious.
Yeah.
And that's why I always say, you know what, a lot of people have tried
mm-hmm.
your recipes at home,
mm-hmm.
but when they came here
yeah.
and they tried, they always said one thing, that the food
yeah.
here was much better than what we cooked at home.
Yeah.
So
that's why, you know.
Yeah, you know, they can
yeah,
always
sure.
come here, and, you know, the reason people come to the restaurant is getting off from cooking.
Yes, that's true. Yeah. Now you can start, you can put in here, Kana, transfer it. Pour it in here.
Ooh, it looks good and hot.
Yes.
So.
Pour a little more, Kana, just pour a little bit inside for the added taste more. So it's a good coconut chutney.
Oh, that was easy and it was fast. So.
Hi viewers, we are back in Madras Palace with Santha today and with her one of a kind of a new recipe, and let's see what she wants us to learn today.
Today I'm going to show you our rasam.
Our language rasam is called like a custom of doing something, but what is your rasam? Let's learn about that.
It's a kind of, you know, spicy lentil or dal soup that we daily use with our meal in South India. It's very popular in South India. So we give our customers as a soup also. For the rasam, all these spices, and I'm going to show you, you know, like tomato rasam.
Mm-hmm.
And there are different types of rasams
okay.
in South India. But we are mainly I'm giving the tomato rasam.
Okay, so that's the most famous one. Okay, so I can see this dal
this is,
here.
Yeah, this is the lentil.
Lentil,
dal.
Yeah.
Yeah, this
we
is
call
the,
it masoor ki dal.
Yeah, yeah. And
right?
This is the cooked dal. And we use in our rasam the cooked dal. Then
like this is cooked or?
Yeah, that's a cooked one.
Okay.
And the spices, the turmeric, chili powder, black pepper, and the jeera, cumin powder, and the mustard seeds.
So you use the whole jeera and the jeera powder too.
Yeah, and garlic. And this is the, what do you call, coriander leaves.
Yeah.
And curry leaves, and salt, and sugar, and lemon juice.
Wow.
Oil.
So let's water, of course,
of course.
Okay.
And the sugar, if you want only, you can add. Otherwise, you don't have.
You don't have.
First, you know, I put the boil that. So it's hot. It's about 3 cups of, you know, water. You should be using 3 cups of water.
Mm-hmm.
And then. Turmeric powder, put in the turmeric powder.
Chili powder according
chili
to
powder,
the taste,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, you shouldn't be putting too much. And half teaspoon of, you know, black pepper.
Yeah, I've noticed in your cooking you use more black pepper than red pepper because,
yeah.
And black pepper is better for the health too.
Yeah, and half teaspoon of jeera powder.
Mm-hmm.
Black pepper and jeera powder is very good for your health, and it clears the, what do you call, if you have a cold or cough, people make this kind of, you know, soup and they drink it. Okay.
And this is a good thing, like a lot of people who are vegetarian, they cannot have chicken soup and stuff.
Yes.
So if they have a cold or they feel that they are coming up with a flu or something, they can have this.
Yes, yeah, sure. And you can use this, you know, what do you call, garlic.
Mm-hmm.
And you had to let it cook for about 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay.
And then about after 15-20 minutes, you had to add about 3 to 4 tablespoons of tomato paste.
Okay. So it gives a nice rich color and flavor both.
Yeah, tomatoes, even for diabetic people, tomato is good, very good. See, that's why we are using this tomato in our rasam, tomato paste. Then I put in a little bit of salt and little sugar. And mix it, stir it well and keep it about 10 minutes to boil.
So that's it, or there's more to it?
Yes, and after 15-20 minutes, you have to put in the
whole tomatoes.
The cut tomatoes.
Cut tomatoes. So do we cook them for so long that they get soft, or you just like to have them like little halfway done or something?
Little, you know, you have to let it cook well.
Okay.
Okay.
So it gets mixed up with the rasam.
Rasam.
So now we'll have to wait for like almost how long? 20 minutes?
Yeah, it's almost, about 20 minutes.
20 minutes?
Yeah.
So viewers, let's see in 20 minutes how this delicious rasam will come out. So Shanta, now it's almost ready. So why do you have this pan on now?
Now I have to season it. The rasam with mustard seeds and jeera.
Okay.
And coriander leaf. And curry leaf. Okay, so let me put some oil, about one to two teaspoonful of oil, and then put the mustard seeds and the jeera. When it pops up, you put in the curry leaf and coriander leaf.
Coriander.
Okay. So it's almost. Okay, now it's almost ready. Okay. Before additional taste, you can do.
do this. And I can see you have some lemon juice, so if I want a little sour,
if you,
we can add
a little bit
lemon juice in it.
Hi, this is the final product, and you can see, you know, how good it looks.
Try this nice, beautiful, and tasty, delicious rasam. I think it's better that you come and try it at Madras Palace. So, see you next time.
Nazreen,